Next lesson about special relativity. Today we want to solve the problem of adding velocities in special relativity. Let's assume that we have two inertial frames of reference, the first and the second. And the second frame of reference is moving with constant speed in the direction of the axis x related to the first frame of reference. We have here an object moving also in the direction of the axis x, and the velocity of this object will be measured by these two observers from the first frame of reference and the second frame of reference. Values are measured in this frame of reference, and O dash to the velocity of this object measured in the second frame of reference. It's equal delta x dash divided by delta t dash. We'll transform this second equation to such form, delta x dash equals O dash times delta t dash. We want to know what value of the velocity of this object will be measured by the observer in the first frame of reference. If observer in the second frame of reference achieved value O dash. If we believed in a Galilei of transformations, the answer for this question would be very simple. Velocity of this object measured in the first frame of reference would be just the velocity measured in the second frame of reference plus v. We know that this equation is not true. It's really easy to prove. Let's assume that this object is just light. Velocity of light is just in the vacuum is just c. So if we put here c, then the speed of light measured in the first frame of reference would be c plus v. It would be greater than the speed of light in the vacuum, and we know that nothing can move faster than light in the vacuum, and that speed of light in all inertial frames of reference is the same and equals c. So we can't use this transformation. We should use a transformation which complies with main postulates of special theory of relativity. This transformation is called Lorentz transformation. I wrote here two equations describing this transformation, but it is a special case of Lorentz transformation. Just the situation, these equations describe such a situation when second frame of reference is moving with constant speed in the direction of the axis x. From these two equations, we can compute delta x dash and delta t dash. As you can see, these equations and these equations are very similar. It is because x dash and t dash depend on x and t linearly. So that both now we have four equations. 1, 2, 3, 4. The only thing we have to do now is just combine these four equations, and it can be done in various ways. I put here the right side of this equation, it's not here. Then I put here the right side of this equation, it's here. Now we see that on both sides we have the same denominator. So if we multiply both sides by the square root of 1 minus v squared by c squared, then these denominators will vanish. Next, we divide both sides of this equation by delta t, and we have it here. Delta t divided by delta t is just 1. Delta t divided by delta t is just 1. Delta x divided by delta t, it is the velocity of this object measured in the first frame of reference. And the same is here. So we have this equation. And now we almost solved our problem. It's enough to transform this equation and calculate from it velocity u, velocity measured in the first frame of reference, and it's done here, or calculate from this equation the velocity u dash, velocity measure of object measured in the second frame of reference, and it's made here. The only thing that we should do now is to prove that these equations they comply with the main postulates of the special theory of relativity. I mean that the speed of light in the vacuum is the same in all the inertial frames of reference. And that there is nothing can move faster than light. It is easy to prove. Let's assume that our object is just light. So u dash is equal c. Now we put c to this equation here and here. And it's done. That is done here. Now we have such an equation. We change the form to this. And we see that the result is u equals c. So the speed of light in both these inertial frames of reference is the same and is equal the speed of light in the vacuum. So now we solved this problem. So it's just the end of this lesson.